When designing learning for the virtual classroom, we need to leverage new tools. Why? Because the virtual learning environment isn't the same as the traditional classroom, so we need to adapt our engagement techniques in order to create meaningful learner-centered programs. One virtual classroom tool to take advantage of is application sharing. Application sharing is a popular feature, and it allows the facilitator to share software applications with participants, even if they don't have the software installed on their individual machines. It can create interaction or collaboration, thus making your content more engaging. When it comes to instructional uses, application sharing is most often used to demonstrate software features. This is a great starting point for other more collaborative exercises like creating case studies and passing control from participant to participant to complete steps in a series, sharing common office software packages for small groups to work with, and role-playing exercises for teaching skills that involve technology. Before designing virtual classroom exercises that involve application sharing, here's what to consider about this tool. We recommend that to understand its capabilities, you should ask, what types of applications can be shared? Can the entire desktop be shared? What are the bandwidth requirements for application sharing? Can participants interact with the application or just view it? Can applications be shared from a participant's desktop? Our Virtual Classroom Instructional Designer Certificate course provides this example of engaging application sharing in action.
We're going to walk through a process for creating interaction in your application sharing or your screen sharing activities. And we're going to ask you as participants here in this course, right, to experience the interactivity in a role play, so to speak. So to do this, JJ is going to share an application for us. All right, so she's going to share out for us. And while she's setting that all up, I'm going to fill you in on the scenario. So here you go. You all want to take a vacation. And you want to make all of the arrangements for this vacation on your own. Right? You want to do it yourself. You don't want to have to involve a travel agent or anybody else. But you really don't know how to do that. So you did some research, you found an online course on navigating Expedia. It's offered by your local community center, so you decided to sign up and take it. I'm going to be your instructor for this course. All right. So we're going to head into our role play now. So I'd like to welcome everybody here to our class on navigating Expedia. Now we're going to start by you following me. And I'm going to show you how to search for available flights based on your destination, the date that you're leaving, and the number of passengers that you're going to be taking with you. All right, so we're going to start by clicking on the Flights Only button. Because at this point, that's all I'm interested in looking for is a flight. Now, I live near the Philadelphia airport. So my flying from destination, I'm going to enter Philadelphia. And typically you'll see that you're going to get a pop-up menu with a list, and you can just, if you find your airport listed there, you could just click on that and it will pre-fill for you. Now, I think that I want to go to San Diego. I've always wanted to go there. I hear it's beautiful. I'm going to see if I can find a flight to San Diego. And it pops up there, so we can just go ahead and click on that. Now I need to come down to the next row. You'll see there's a field there for your departing date. I'm going to leave on Saturday, August 1st. So I have to advance to bring up the August calendar. You can just click on August 1st, and that will pre-fill for you. Now, I don't know about you, but I really need a vacation. So I'm going to stay for 2 weeks, and I'm going to come back on August 15th. Now, next, Expedia here is asking me how many are traveling with me. How many is in my party? Well, like I just said, I really need a vacation, so I'm going to go by myself. So it already has one there. I'm just going to keep that one selected. Now we'll go over to children. Currently, it has zero there. Again, I really need a vacation. I am leaving the children home, so I'm going to keep this as it is. I'm happy with what I have. I'm leaving from Philadelphia. I'm heading to San Diego. My departure date's August 1st. My return date's the 15th. It's just me. I'm ready to go ahead and click search at the bottom left corner and see what flights can pop up for me that I can select to take my trip. So that is how you do a search for flights only.
Your audience members will be accustomed to seeing application sharing in a webinar type of environment, but they'll likely be surprised to see it used so collaboratively. InSync training provides more information about virtual classroom tools, including application sharing, in the white paper titled Virtual Classroom Tool Design Basics, a Virtual Engagement Primer. Download it for free under Resources White Papers at www.insyncTraining.com. Additionally, our Virtual Classroom Instructional Designer Certificate course provides in-depth application design instruction. To learn more or register, visit www.insyncTraining.com and select the Certificates drop-down on the top left-hand side of the homepage. The links for both the white paper and course are included in the video description below.